again. Have you ever wondered why sometimes your characters pop and other times they don't? It happens to the best of us, and sometimes it even makes it past multiple rounds of editing and ends up on the printed page and on the shelf of chapters. This is embarrassing and detracts from the story anytime it happens, but there's one character it can happen to that will have devastating effects on your novel, your lead. While other characters may be more entertaining or even interesting, your lead is the hook on which every other event in your story is hung. It's his story. Pardon the male pronoun there, by the way. I've got nothing against female protagonists. I'll use they from now on. The first thing to make sure of in developing your lead is that they are three-dimensional. I know that sounds obvious, but you'd be surprised how often it's not. A lot of books and movies feature one-note characters, and it absolutely drives me insane. Think of yourself. Do you act the same way towards your mother as you do your partner? Or your friend? Or your boss? Of course not. We all wear different hats at different times, and so should your character. Sit down with a list of your characters and figure out how your lead interacts with each of them. Does he love them? Does he hate them? Is he attracted to them? I don't know, but you should. This also means having the character fleshed out at the start of the story. It really draws a reader in when characters are already fully formed, real people. Let's use an example from my own work, if I can. Take Victor from Infinity. He's enigmatic, and the reader knows very little about him. But I do. I know everything about him. I even know where he went to high school. I'm not telling you that yet, though. I simply know it ahead of time so that he can react appropriately to the situations that I put him in. The result works very well. There's a reason that we, as fans, love characters like Mal from Firefly and dislike characters like Bella Swan from Twilight. It helps when the writers know what they're doing ahead of time. That said, a big part of your character is dialogue. This is what makes your character believable, and almost all suspension of disbelief hinges on it. Nicholas Brendon once said of Buffy the Vampire Slayer, "It's realistic. Well, the things that happen aren't realistic, but the way people respond to them are." What he's saying is true. It doesn't matter that a dragon just came out of the floor. If your character responds realistically to it, it will be bought by the reader. If it's real to them, it'll be real to the reader. On the flip side, if you claim your character's a scientist and they get every single scientific fact wrong that they say, his and your credibility are just gone. Also, if you say they're grim but all they do is joke around, you've undermined yourself there too. As a side note, it's better not to say your character is anything. Just let your reader decide for themselves. But that's a rant for another time. Another point is not to let them be passive. This one's not so obvious. A lot of professional writers do this, myself included from time to time, embarrassingly. A good example is Jennifer Connelly's character from The Strangers. The character here is frustratingly passive. She doesn't affect the plot. The plot just happens to her. This isn't just bad character development. It's bad storytelling. To use an example from literature, as I really should be, the character of Dexter Morrigan from Darkly Dreaming Dexter is, in my mind, very passive. Unlike the show, with the first season of which is based upon this book, Dexter spends no time actively involved with the events of the Ice Truck Killer plot. They just seem to happen around him, and he comments on them in his witty interior monologue all the way. But this can only entertain for so long, as readers tend to lose interest in passive characters. Who would you rather watch, the person driving a speeding car, or the guy sitting in the back seat gazing lazily out the window? Make the character an active part of the plot. Make their actions affect the story and the world around them. If it's a crime story, have them hunt bad guys rather than simply react to their actions. If it's a love story, make the character be proactive in his relationship rather than just reacting to their partner. This, above almost anything else, makes engaging stories. Once that's all done, be consistent in how you've portrayed them. Nothing comes out of left field more than a character acting in a way that doesn't jive with the rest of what you've told us. That said, they can't remain the same throughout either. Characters have to move over an arc. They have to grow and be different at the end of the tale than they were at the beginning of it. I know this all seems like a lot and some of it seems contradictory, but once you hit that sweet spot, you'll know it. Your main character will be like a real person to you, and you'll know how they'll react and the things they'll say as readily as you would a friend you've known for years. Be sure to like and subscribe if you found this helpful, and above all else, keep writing.